Смысл семинара заключается в том, чтобы мы в нашем объединении начали ощущать присутствие Творца. Вот такими последовательными, четкими направлениями на вместе, так как я нарисовал здесь, нам надо найти между нами проявление Творца. В этом заключается весь смысл семинара. Поэтому не надо нам особенно умничать, надо устремляться именно поддержать всех остальных, быть вместе с остальными. И в соответствии с этим первый вопрос. Почему мы получаем помехи в нашей личной жизни и в группе, и в мире? Почему мы получаем все время помехи? Почему все время что-то плохо не складывается? Почему это происходит? Прошу.
Why do we get this? Disturbances constantly in our life. Why do we constantly get disturbances in our life, in our work, in the group, in our study, in everything? So this is the first question, and this is what we are learning. The resistance is necessary for us to have it as an point through which we can measure our work, through which we can make this effort and join above each disturbance we face.
Well, we get the disturbances in order to connect, in order to connect between us, in order to connect with the Creator. And recently I'm discovering the beauty and joy in such disturbance as you know, thoughts that didn't have to do with connection. Sometimes they are against connection, sometimes they are just as if neutral. But still, thanks to the Kabbalists' advices, we have an opportunity to connect even such thoughts to the goal, even such thoughts to the Creator who gave them to us. And that's great.
There's, you know, there's nothing else besides him, and in my opinion, Creator on purpose sends the obstacles, disturbances to us, family and group, actually. So in my opinion, to grow our desire, to grow our longing to him, and to find out and to discover his love.
We're in a long process. Process isn't easy. I always like to think about the disturbances like if you're at the beach and you have the big waves. Sometimes you got to dive under the big waves. Sometimes you jump over the big waves. Sometimes you get on a surfboard and you surf the big waves. But the waves are always there. It's just how you deal with them. And the waves get stronger and stronger as you get deeper and deeper. And it's good. But if you turn your back on the wave, you get knocked over. But then you get right back up and you know, I'm going to grab my board, I'm going to surf, I'm going to use that wave and have fun with it. It's not just fun, it's I'm going to move forward with it.
I think that it could not be a movement, it could not be progress without opposite power, and by this we getting disturbances that to correct attention to our goal.
Okay, let's try to see what will happen if we will not have disturbances, obstacles. How, in which state we will be? You know, it's very funny. It's you can just see that when you don't have disturbances, if you don't pay attention, you can be very far away from the goal easily. You don't have a way to check how do you react. Compare related to this force is because each time you see a disturbance, you can see the measurement that you have on the importance, how you see the friends, the goal, where are your thoughts. It's really such a big help, a tools that allow you to measure exactly are you touch or do you just don't care about the disturbances. You are just inside your friends. It's sort of help.
We need the resistance, and only from resistance we could become some understanding. From one part, these problems come from outside world. From another part, it's our questions in the heart, and they are mixing. It's a big cocktail, and after that, we are understanding where is the point of truth, and we're becoming the power to make a forward, one step forward, two steps, and so on, and we are becoming the clearance of desire, so we could mixing with our friends and to grow up together.
Great to hear all friends what we're talking. It's great to hear all friends, you know, all answers and all true answers from the heart. Going to the question, all problems which we have in the groups in our lives is real answer for us, and it's like a map showing, you know, which way we're going, and in this path you can't go just straight line. You're going up and down, and every single moment when you're going down or you have any issues, you're just showing that you need to bring all your thoughts to the goal. Don't remember why we are in this path. Don't remember why we're doing this together, but that we're creating something new together. And this is just showing, like friends said, measurements where we are in this path.
I think it's a part of our happiness to know that the whole world around me is my laboratory. And maybe disturbances is not the right word, but it's a gift that shows us, okay, you can adjust a bit more there, you can adjust a bit more there. And we know that we should allow the light to work on all these things. And growing that way makes us better in the group. And when we are among the friends and we grow as a person, as a point, we can attract more light together. So we must always realize these two things. What comes to us comes from Him, and it's only meant to be good. And what we do is for Him, is for His glory, for His pleasure. That keeps us going. So let's be happy with these disturbances.
If we have a game, when we have a game, and in the game, let's say, things are not going well for us, so we are about to lose, right? And this we can consider as a disturbance. But in a game, we perceive things differently. We are not so... we are excited in a way, but we know it's a game. So it's not a big deal if we lose, right? But in a life, if and especially in a group, if we walk, perceive things very, we give big importance. We work even on the importance. And the real disturbance come when things touch our ego. It is like the nerve in the teeth when the dentist touch the nerve. And I think this is the real disturbance when we are about to leave, when we are about, oh, that's enough. I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not going to even try to connect. And I think that this is the real disturbance that is giving us hard time. And in these moments, if we are able to get out of ourselves and watch the whole thing as a game, as we are in a game, then we will see the true meaning of the disturbance. Then we will find the reason and understand it.
Okay, I think the Creator have to give us something really huge, really big, really incredible, such a huge force, light. But for that, we need a desire on the same size. Yes, but our desire is small, and how we can grow our desire only by solving these problems what we're getting. Yes, solving, this is how it is in the life. Yes, you're solving the problem, you're getting better, you're getting forgot the word. Okay, this is for growing the desire. I think we get all the problems.
Yes, and each disturbance, each event is in fact a step that is offered to us on which to climb on. It's opportunity, and the smaller disturbance it gets, and most seriousness, as some of you said, is understood by us as communication of the Creator with myself, with us, is more rapidly we are climbing these steps toward each other.
The disturbances make us and help us to take the Creator seriously, to take the matters we deal with seriously, meaning the group, this world, any material we study. They make us take everything serious and actually prepare to taste what is inside the connection.
We sometimes feel bad, and we sometimes get angry at the friends, or in external words, it's the same. And all the obstacles maybe is coming from, of course, coming from Creator, and He wants to say, "Hey, it's me." I say, "Oh yes, it's you." After that, we just the same things happen to us, and after that, you did me. Oh, I didn't you. Am I right? But He said, "Oh, it's me. It's my." Is over here. Okay, there's none else besides Him. Every time He wants to remind us, there is none else besides me. That's me, not any other, not your friends. You are not, your friends are not. Just to remind us.
I think to continue what Timo said, it's the purpose is really to start to have a dialogue with the Creator, how I'm going to institute this dialogue. And even when you take you need to have a dialogue between two entities, you need to have some protocol. So here we are establishing the protocol without the creature and the creator through things that appear in my life, and I need to recognize him. It's not always easy. I want to say that it's because of that or because of this. Sometimes it's painful. But in the same time, the help comes that when you have some difficulties and you have to call your friends or send an SMS, ask them help, you can see, wow. At the end of the day, you can see that it's really a help. First of all, you see that the friends are helpful, and also you see that it was really a help to connect to them. After a while, you can see the obstacle from the side and say that, wow, it was really just to connect me, and recognize that it's because you were not connected enough that you had to see that, and this and so and so.
I just remembered, as an example, like a kid trying to learn something. So all those troubles what we were having in the groups, between us, between friends, is just showing, we can look to the kid, to the child, baby, and how strong desire he has to learn something. That desire is he has from nature. So, and all the time he's going up again, he's trying.
Как мы можем не уничтожать помехи, не пытаться их аннулировать, не пытаться их закрасить, не пытаться начать радоваться, а их как бы зачеркнуть, забыть о них? Как нам подняться над ними, то есть сохранить их, а мы выше их, то есть одновременно существовать в двух ощущениях. Внутри меня существуют помехи, а я над ними поднимаюсь и, связываясь с остальными, их правильно использую. Еще раз повторяю. Как нам не уничтожать помехи, а с их помощью подниматься над ними. Тогда мы поднимаемся на следующую ступень. Как нам это сделать? Благодарить Творца за это, за то, что Он нам их дает. Ощутить эти помехи как призыв Творца подняться. Как нам найти эти силы? Как нам совершить этот подъем? Внизу помеха, а мы над ней. Прошу.
As friend said, we have to realize that the group is our tool towards the connection with the Creator. And when we undergo, when we go over the disturbances inside of us, when we finally understand that is our ego that is giving us hard time, and no matter of that, we still go and continue and give effort and keep trying to connect. This is the way we invest, and we learn more things about the connection, more things about ourselves and our friends and the group and how is this all working. We start feeling them, and in this way, when the disturbance come to me, when the disturbances come to us, we start seeing what is the Creator telling us through all these things. The emotions are appearing and they're like an arrow showing us where we should look at. And with communicating in the group, we we are developing this language. We are learning the language of talking with the Creator.
When the blows come, the disturbances, I am constantly trying to interpret what the Creator is trying to say to me. Scrutinies are, you learn a lot about yourself, you learn a lot about your ego, you learn about your relation to your friends. At the same time, it doesn't always happen the first day, that's for sure, and you're feeling this anger or hurt or whatever you're going through. I always find the answer in the lessons. So if I'm watching the lesson 2 hours a day, or I watch the lesson 3 hours a day, and I catch the meal, and I'm constantly looking for, because every time I have a problem, the only place I really find the answers is in the lessons.
That's great that you say that, and I can add that every time I watch the lesson, I feel two things. First thing, I always feel, wow, this lesson is specially for me. And the other thing is that although you are part in a group, for me the Dutch group, I know there's so many people watching. I see on the screen the friends from Petah Tikva, but from Moscow, from St. Petersburg, from everywhere. And then speaking of a group without even knowing all the persons, this is a worldwide group. You're part of, being part of Bnei Baruch is not limited to your country. And this attracts me to the lesson. It's hard to skip because you know they're all there. And then you're there, and then you see this lesson was only for me.
The question to not make disappear the obstacles, it's at the beginning it's not very easy, because we can see that when there is different state. When the obstacles come first, you want him to disappear, and then after that, you start to see that no, actually it's Enod Milvado. You are in the study more, you study more, and then you understand through the friends, the lesson, that there is none else beside him. And then suddenly you see that, okay, now I want to use the obstacles. And when you start to be aware that now I want to use the obstacle as a help, then the obstacle becomes slippery.
How to say? Slippery.
Yeah.
Or slippery?
Yeah, slippery. Yeah, that they want to run away. So you see the obstacles, and then you want to play and not to make it disappear, but the obstacle disappear, you know. It's like suddenly so it's become like a fish that you take from the water. You cannot hold it in your hand, and finally you start to see that actually the way to do that is just to increase the importance of the goal, the importance of the friends. And then the obstacle is still there. Maybe you can have a big problem, something that you don't have the solution, and maybe the friends also don't have the solution, but you are trying just to increase the importance of the friends, of the goal. And then suddenly you see that you look at it differently.
I think we got to change our evaluation system, yes, from sweet and sour, yes, to right or wrong. And then all the problems which come to me, you are handling them absolutely different. You see them like help, and that's it. And you work with the problems, yes, it's not disappears, but you don't feel it anymore like it's bad for you, yes.
I think that all disturbances and all the problems have only one goal, is to connect with others. And if in social life, we can see too that all disturbances is to connect with other peoples in society. In our way, all disturbances must be to more stronger connection or to correct connection or to remember about connection in any way and connect in another way with our friends, with our group, with our system, with our teachers, with everything what is our. I see only one goal of connections is this.
Yes, whether there is a great disturbance as a hatred, as a really great resistance toward the study, or maybe even more dangerous disturbance in the form of indifference to friends, to study, there is no chance I can have any means to rise above it, except the group, except building this strong, forceful environment that will be able, that I will make able to pick me up, to make me go above, by not losing any of these feelings, because I don't have really neither means or forced to get away from them, except running away from the group and trying to go totally wrong way, but to really make me sit down and, like you said, sit on the lesson and come to the Congress and to do anything. And this way, my original feeling is not lost, but I gain unity, I gain group, I gain you.
I think the most wonderful stuff in the studying what we have, it's a unifying of absolutely disappointing points of each other, absolutely the front of points. And obstacles, in principle, it's our feeling, it's absolutely another point of creator in by us. But from one side, we are becoming with obstacles a stone heart. But if we are, like friends speaking, with the lessons, we have to make with this process, we could make it warmer into our heart and to understand what must we receive. It's a question of the taste. And with this taste, we are understanding this language, and we are understanding that we must to change some stuff inside to make this ideal that they have each of us. Each of us has this wonderful poets in the heart. And but how could we know how it will be possible to make it? And so it's a sign from him to make the step toward.
Well, I can fight a problem in a direct way, or I can annul it, which is roughly the same. But I don't have to. I would have to do that if I were at an animal state and I had no way out. But I can annul myself before the environment instead of annulling the obstacle. And this is how I race to another step. The lowest step is fighting the problem in a direct way or annulling it. A higher step is rising above it. And even a higher step...
Значит, я могу работать над помехами как герой, идти в лоб, подниматься над ними, показывать другим, какой я герой, как я умею, вопреки себя, подавлять себя, подниматься над собой. Я показываю это товарищам. И у меня есть на это силы продемонстрировать себя перед всей группой, помогать им, давать им хороший пример, помогать другим группам в том, что вот смотрите, какие мы, как я, или как наша группа целая, как мы поднимаемся в атаку и так далее, над нашим эгоизмом, приподнимаемся над ним, даем ему в зубы, и при этом оказываемся еще большими эгоистами. Потому что делаем это якобы самостоятельно, не призывая на помощь Творца. Это самая большая ошибка. То есть первая ошибка – это то, что пришло какое-то отягчение души. Я падаю и не могу подняться. Вторая ошибка – если я поднимаюсь и сам пытаюсь быть героем, преодолеть трудности. Это еще большая ошибка. Как мне не забыть, что преодолевать трудности мне надо именно с помощью Творца. Не делать из себя сильного героя, а наоборот. Да, я не в состоянии, вот пускай Творец мне поможет. Я хочу быть вместе с Ним. Я зову Его. Потому что Он сам дал мне эти трудности для того, чтобы я призвал Его и таким образом раскрыл Его, соединился с Ним. Как нам не забывать об этом? Что при любых трудностях сразу же мы должны бросаться к Нему. Вопрос? Как нам не забывать, что не надо самим преодолевать никаких трудностей, не надо нам ничего делать самим в этом мире, кроме как требовать Его работы, Его проявления, Его раскрытия именно на тех проблемах, которые Он нам делает. И в этом заключается излечение, исправление всех этих проблем в самом лучшем виде. Как нам не забывать, организовать себя так, чтобы сразу же, мгновенно, в каждый момент времени я сразу же обращался к Нему еще, еще, еще. И не оставлял бы это. Никогда. Прошу.
Okay, only to repeat. How can we not... How can we organize ourselves to not forget that all these difficulties is coming from the Creator and that we need His help instead of trying to rise above them on our own.
I think this stuff was rough described. It's most difficult. These things, what Rav said, it's the most difficult thing. Because these two conclusions, it's absolutely logical. It's only these two variants we have in this world. Only these two. But for this third variant, we must discover Him. Because only with this discovering, you have the possibility to make it. Because you have a pain in this moment, and you don't have possibility to go from this pain and to stay in this pain, and of course you need this third dimension, and you must feel this dimension, and maybe it's a possibility to discover this dimension with your friends, and maybe.
Once Rav said that Creator does His plan, does her plan, according to the people whose hearts awaken. So actually this is a treasure. The group is treasure. The group is treasure. So, and how can we organize that everything is coming from Creator? Because Creator just chosen us. But in the group, we always see the greatest, the other friends, but not internal words, people. So he does every plan according to us. And there is none else besides him. There is no free will. There is no free choice, but only how do I behave towards my friends. It is the area. It is the football area where you can play. You can go or you can go to the outs. So, and you can use the corner. It's up to us how to behave our friends. So, the old obstacles from Creator, because he wants to understand. He wants to give us much more, more longing, more desire.
It's really a very, very hard question, and I can't find the answer. And by this, I'm asking you to help me to find it.
Do you mind to repeat the question?
How can we organize ourselves not to?
So how can we organize among ourselves not to forget to ask of the Creator for the help to overcome any obstacle, any disturbance, instead of trying to be heroes and doing it our own?
It's so great to be in a circle of friends and listen to their desire, which is talking. Just a really great example we had now in the lesson when Rav told that just try to close your eyes and everything around you is just Creator. So we need to try to inspire our friends to show the importance of a goal, to understand together, try how great is to be together, how unity is great, how great is to help each other and work together. Yes.
We need to try to come to a point on oneself that what we heard on a lesson today also, that we not fall beneath this point. And this is my decision to give myself up, to give myself to friends, and that nothing else really matters. There are times like for coming for this Congress, I'm sure for most of us, if not all, that there is no one or two or three specific disturbance, but all of them, you name it, nothing is telling person to go to unite with friends and to try to just close your eyes and step forward into the darkness, and there is this light.
In my personal experience, I try to be in a conversation with the Creator. And sometimes you have the same experience with the group. Sometimes you have the same experience with the teacher. And the hardest part in all those relationships is annulling yourself to the higher power of the Rav, the group, the Creator. And if you constantly remember that you're small and everything else in this world is greater than you, then you it makes it easier to ask for help. But annulling yourself is the thing that I find the hardest. It's constant work for me. It's very hard for me. I'm a problem solver by nature. I didn't, before I understood that where it all came from, I always felt that I was the one with the magic key. But I don't
Я повторяю any... вопрос. Как не забывать, что во всем мы должны просить Творца? Как не забывать, что каждую минуту мы должны только просить Творца? Потому что каждую минуту Он определяет мне мое состояние, мою жизнь. Как мне постоянно обращаться к Нему? Кто меня может к этому все время толкать? Как нам организоваться, чтобы я все время ощущал направление, толчок? Вот как маленький ребенок, постоянно его направляют. И тогда он растет, правильно растет. Как мне сделать так, чтобы меня правильно направляли? Прошу.
I think that the group is the masterpiece to help me to not forget. In the way that I give up myself in the group, because in general sometimes when I have an obstacle, I don't want even to sometimes to talk about that in the group. I think I can do it myself, you know. And it's really like when I see that I'm at the wall, that I go in the group. So we should not wait to be in this place, but to give up. Everything can be in the group. I heard one day, the job, the wife, everything that you are crossing, you can bring it in the group on the table with your friends. So only to demand the Creator to not forget and sticking on the group can be the help I see.
When we look to our hand, it's the beast, right? And the beast wants things and takes, doesn't want to nullify, doesn't care, just wants to take and receive. And that's why people don't like to go in the army, because there is something straight, there is the framework that is making us not forget what are we doing and why are we there. So the thing that we have to do is have the framework very straight, very tight, and hardcore, just to remind us all the time. Every half an hour, read an intention. Every 1 hour, call a friend. Never late for the lesson. All the time be ready, and all the time scrutinize. Keep notes in your pockets and pull them out in every moment. All the time, we have to create together a framework for the whole Europe, for the whole world, clear, a really tight framework, just like soldiers. If we are spiritual warriors, we have to be even more hardcore than the army warriors. That's
I think it's a really, like you said, it's a mutual question for all us. Undepends from Europe or America or Russia, Israel and so on. And I think that we must together to make one system, big system for all us, a virtual system with computer, laptops and our smartphones and so on. And every time, maybe one time an hour and one time in half hour, it will become some kind of reminding, and of course, and we could also to participate in this stuff and to change the system with each other.
Yes, I see that as most important to unit all things what we are doing in our lives, all what is family, or what is our job, or what is our most important things, in our life to one Jain, and this Jain must be united with a group, and we must have very hard, very correct schedule plan of the day, schedule plan of the day, and and of course, I think this will help to understand, to remember.
Кроме нас, наших групп, нашей объединенной европейской группы, существует еще огромное количество людей. Весь континент, Европа, которые находятся в проблеме, которая тоже исходит от Творца. Как мы можем напоминать им о том, что проблема не в них, а в Творце? Объяснить им это невозможно. Мы объясняем это через объединение, что если вы объединитесь, начнете объединение, тогда вы избавитесь от проблем. Почему их объединение без всяких связей с Творцом достаточно для того, чтобы избавиться от проблем? Вопрос. Почему достаточно европейским народам, если они начнут объединяться, избавиться от проблем, не обращаясь к Творцу? Прошу.
So why is it enough for European nations to only unite among themselves and they don't need the Creator?
I don't think it's enough. I think that it's if they're uniting with the wrong intention, that the problems only continue and just get much worse.
It's not only about Europe, it's about all the other countries. You said right, the intention is very important, but there's none else besides him. And the sense is also coming from Creator. And so how can we correct the wrong intentions? Of course, by praying before pray, first of all. It's all about the intention.
I think if Europe unites without a creator, we unite in corporeal forces. We know that the solution for every problem comes from the light, and light is only there if we unite with the creator. So, uniting Europe or whatever countries without a creator is definitely no option.
I think it's a question of the Congress, in principle. And I'm coming here to become also the answer for these questions, but what could I say from my opinion? It's that we must find the most strong troubles in the society, and these troubles must be the mutual for all levels of the people, independent from money stuffs or power stuffs. For example, family troubles and children troubles, education trouble, and to begin to show the absolutely easy example. For example, when the man and woman are together, they are winning together, and also the children are winning, and the all participants are winning together. And after that, the next step, it's to make a relationship between these families, for example, like Rav said, and to show that this peace, the people finding, gives the power to arrive material level, health level, and so on, and all of winning without Creator.
I think, of course, there are now, there's no way they could do it, but if we start talking, when they start talking, we saw this when we went to the UN, they started using our language, but if they start talking about the fact that the reason they're uniting is because the action of each person, the action of each nation, the action of each community affects all the other communities, then without bringing the Creator into it, it is the spirit of the Creator. And I think that's the bridge we need to cross in order to help them.
I see that we have enough power, or less, to have enough power, to get enough power to organize for Europe society and other societies strong reclam company, which will make in society the unity modern thing, but unity will be modern. And what about intention? I think intention we will make in our factory is not their work, not their job. It's our job. And in this connect between us and society, everything will be all right.
И продолжить.
Yes, if we do our job, if we do why are we put here by him, it will be more automatic action for the 99%, and this is something that is our job, because we all already see the results of these actions. Never mind that it's not consciously inside us, but when you look at the television, you see the marketing, the TV shows, everything is around analyzing our desires. It's amazing how already you could just took the point of one commercial from a TV, just this final few seconds, and instead the brand you put Creator or Light or Kabbalah or Unity, and you have a finished product ready for this purpose.
Последний вопрос, самый главный. Как мы можем помочь всем европейским группам получить, приобрести новый формат. Как мы можем помочь всем европейским группам обрести новый формат, чтобы быть объединенными между собой, поддерживать друг друга, как одно общее целое, этим воздействовать на разобщенную Европу, чтобы она почувствовала, что ей тоже надо объединяться, и быть проводником в Европу Света Творца. Как нам переформатировать себя? Прошу.
Question again. It's how can we help all the European groups to get acquire this new format that we are talking from the beginning of the Congress, to unite among us as one whole group, European group, and to through that to influence all the European countries, people, and pass the light to EU.
We know from all the lessons and all the readings that the only solution is in our connection. And we speak about unity, but when I speak for myself, I really don't know what I'm talking about. So the solution is in connection. I can say connection 100 times, but I don't know what it means. Actually, I am here to get that. I cannot make any solution for Europe or the European groups, because I know it is in our connection, and I don't know what connection is. Beat me with that.
Just to set this question, I have an idea that we must to find some game between all our groups, and I have no idea what kind of game. But now, I think after this idea came that it will be some kind like TV of Europe community. It could be TV, internet TV, not expensive, just simple TV. And if we all between wondering about programs, about what to say, about how to say, I think it could be a good project for our connection.
I think there has to be a change of values, just like there has to be a change of values for the people of the continent. Wanting a different type of connection between and amongst each other. And I agree with what you say. I don't think it's a game. I think it's group work, and creating mutual group work for the entire continent will bring everybody together. It will force people to do it. At the same time, it means that we need a better connection from Europe to Israel, and that needs to be a constant connection. And the last part is that all the groups need, you know, not stop thinking themselves as groups, but to have better interconnection through the work with each other. So if we accomplish this, then there's no question that we could accomplish it with the entire continent.
I think that all the group of Europe must join together in a project of dissemination for the integral education. This is really the priority. We maybe it's just an idea that I have like that. Maybe
the friends of Europe can start to think about a congress of integral education, not a congress of Kabbalah, but a congress that will promote the value of integral education with a lot of journalists, with a big marketing in Europe, inviting personality, showing what we are doing, showing the example to make them feel this warm, that it will not be a congress of Kabbalah, but with a lot of paparazzi and journalists and TV from all the Europe. There's so many also independent TV on internet that have that promote this idea that we can touch. So it's a big project that could involve all the group after 6 or 8 months and talk with that with Israel. I'm sure it is very challenging and they will appreciate.
I think it's very interesting minds, and I think with this project we have the possibility to lose the form of some groups that we have in Europe, and then it could be one group in Europe. Why? Because we have two possibilities: to make one big project like network in Europe. It must be network project, and we must organize some stuff, some camps, some congresses, little congresses, big congresses, and so on. And it must be like regular for the people. And the most important stuff of this congress, it's glad, it's a feeling. It's a feeling, and after that, we are also, like Terence said, we must make educations for many, and in absolutely modern form, we must to prepare our psychologist tenses, knowledges, our communication tasks, and so on and so on. We must make one same catering, and for what, like inside part, it will be our groups to become intention, to become this warm, to become fire, to become this feeling between us. And I think we have to make it together, like a ballistic, for example, between us, to make this for between us, and like dissemination, like big outside forum for all us.
Maybe this word can be, should be reminded, whatever happens in this world, it has a roots. Mm-hmm. It is the echo of the upper verse. And Ralph said that if there is a thing just come out very badly, maybe and probably it's very good in the upper worlds, in the roots, in the root of the soul, in the roots. So this may be because the problems when it starts is after the desert, after this congress in Israel. So it is very, very big census there, over there. It's very big explosion there, and it is normal. It's very good what's happening in the upper worlds. It's normal, just echo that, just like this. We don't know it, only Creator.
In the course of preparation for this Congress, there was a brilliant workshop that the friends...
I want to see like you, I want to feel what you feel. I want to sing to you, I want to cling to you, I want to make this love real. You and me.
Thank you.
till we see through the dark. Please take this selfish thirst and make the universe just like the point in our heart.
Лехаем. Okay, friends, please.